Yeah, but she's making a sophomore appearance on The Breakfast Show. She has a voice that can make angels sleep.
Cry.
Like they should be sleeping, by the way. Angels on them. Okay, but then we have Ruby Gyang in the house once again. It's always great to have you on the show. Yay. Great to have you. Welcome.
Thank you for having
great
me.
Great to have you. Wow. As you've been up to so very much. You've been up to very much. So come on, let's have a sneak peek into what you've been up to. What have you been up to?
I mean, over the past year, I got signed to Chocolate City.
Yes!
Yes. I was Loopy Music before then, but then there was a merger of Loopy Music and Chocolate City. MI became the CEO of Chocolate City Music.
You know, I didn't expect that.
Really? Who else do you think they'll put?
No, yeah, but, okay, no, MI, like, who else will they
like
put?
The chairman.
You know, we'll get to what we're talking about. But then I was thinking, because considering that Aldo just left, and I was thinking that, okay, maybe he would want a business-oriented person more than a star.
Yeah.
I don't know if someone trying to say, yes, record labels have stars head. But then I was thinking, okay, since it was a business person that was the head, he might want a business person to, you know, that's what I really. Someone came up and was like, it was going to be MI. I was like, no, it can't be MI.
You know what's funny is MI has a business degree. That's
okay.
One.
Whoa.
Exactly.
Ooh. Okay, yes. now.
That's what he studied in the States before he came to Nigeria. That's one, too.
Wow.
Who better than someone that is both an artist and a business person at the
definitely
same time?
I you know because business degree.
What is good about him is that he knows what it means to be an artist. So when we're having those conversations, is not there's a tendency for business people to not get what artistry is about. Awesome. But he understands that, so he can connect with the artist and then he can also connect with business as well. So he actually was a great choice.
Was he handpicked, or you guys had a chance to vote, like, oh, I want this person, I want myself?
No, it was, I mean, it was basically presented to him like, guy, what do you think? And he's like, okay, I'm gonna do it. So for Aldo, who has done such a super job with Chocolate City, to hand it over to him, he wouldn't do that lightly, and he felt like this is the person that I think can take Chocolate City into the future. So that was last year for me. So my EP called This Is Love is finally out. I know the last time I came, I probably talked to you guys about it. But because of the merger, we kind of had to chill on individual projects as artists.
Okay.
So we first put out the CBM project, the compilation album.
Yeah.
That came out first. I had a couple singles off of them, but I was just waiting. This year, February, I was like, the month of love, my project has to come out. So it's out. The video Shakara is out as well, featuring Ajebutter 22. So I've really kind of been busy this year. I started off
with
running, performing quite a bit. So
That's great.
Okay.
That's great.
The phone lines are open if you want to talk to Ruby. The numbers to call in 0809-1-222-83-45-6. Let's really, this is 7 songs. Some albums just have 4 songs and 3 instrumentals.
No, this is actually an EP. It's not even the album. It's just songs I've had for a while that I felt like I wanted to put out. You know, because there's a tendency, if you feel you have songs, you're like, oh, I have songs. You're not necessarily focusing on what is new and fresh.
If you're doing an album,
you know, so
you,
I mean, maybe 12 songs, 12 to 14.
This is like an album,
you know? So no, it's an EP.
Okay. It's not an album.
It's not an album. Okay. EP is like, we call it, it's like a mini album.
A mini album.
So you just
just a little.
Exactly. Just, you know, put it all together. So I'm really excited about it. It talks it's called This Is Love. And because for me, I feel like love has different expressions, love has different colors, feels. So
yes. What is love to you?
So just for me, I think that there's love that is sad, sad love. Mm. There's love that is angry. There is love that is infatuation. There is love.
That love?
Yes, it's a form of love.
You
know, there is the love that is the love you have for yourself, and there's the love that you have for the opposite sex. So on this project, I talk about different kinds of love. Each song represents a kind of love, in my view.
Now I'm taking something very personal.
Yes.
Good Man remix.
Yes.
I don't know. I feel Good Man is
okay.
It's on its own. It's in a class of its own. But remixing it, why choose to remix it?
I mean,
understand him doing a collaboration with for another song, but why Good Man?
Do you know, it's funny, they called, it was Kobams, it was Bez's manager that was like, Ruby, this song is hard. We need to do something with it. We need to, do you understand? Because I never even thought about doing a remix as such. Okay. But they were like, we need to do it. And if Kobams calls, you go. Like, are you kidding me?
It's all right, a lot of artists there too.
Yes.
Collaborations.
Did they
call too?
No, those ones I had been, you know how you make a list and you wish and you're like, oh my God, I would love to work with this person. 2008, I was in Jos. I saw Nneka for the first time on TV and I was like, oh my God, what I would give to do a song with this lady. Now we're talking almost 7 years later, I finally got to do a song with her.
Wow.
She was so cool. No air. She was like, okay, I like the song, I'll do it. Quick,
beautiful,
she did the song.
Beautiful, that song. What's the song about?
It's
what
called
part of
Beautiful.
Love? What type of love,
love
is that
for
song?
Yourself. You know, as women, there's so much pressure. I don't know if men face it, but there's so much pressure on us to look a certain way, to to weigh a certain way, to be a certain complexion, to have certain attributes.
We feel it in a different way.
Okay, you feel it, right?
No, let me tell you how we feel it.
Money.
I mean, not money. You've seen that. Have you seen that picture before where a lady is looking at the mirror? She's skinny, but then she sees a fat woman in the mirror. Well, you are skinny. You are looking. We overlove ourselves. We are looking both in the mirror.
Nice.
And that's
nice.
Different way. You know, ladies and guys tend to see differently. The lady always thinks she's not good enough.
I disagree.
Exactly.
No, I agree.
Most of
some
the time.
Ladies actually overlove themselves.
But do you know there are few? There are
I don't.
Not
yeah,
so
yeah,
many.
Yeah. I said majority of ladies just they don't think they're always good enough. For guys, they always think they are better than what they are.
Like, I think women need to learn a little something from that. You know, it's about perception.
My mirror image, if she come here, oh my God.
He's probably Denzel.
Guy in his mind. In his mind.
I'm telling you.
But if beautiful is self-love, then what is high?
High is that infatuation love. It is that you meet someone, you're attracted to that person, they just blow your mind. That first initial attraction you meet when you're first falling in love with someone is a high. Of course, that high doesn't last forever because it's,
Word. No, go on. I was just comparing with you.
It doesn't last forever, but it's very important. That initial attraction is what brings a man and a woman together. So this song is just saying, I didn't drink, I didn't smoke, but I'm high. And, you know, I remember your kiss, I remember your touch, I remember your lips. That's why I'm high. But so that's high.
Let's do a little bit of helping some other people here now. How do we get, after the high phase, let's talk to a young couple out there. You know, there was that time when you hear the person's name and there are elephants in your stomach.
Yes.
The butterfly, you know, the elephants are flying.
Stampede.
You know, but then it gets to a point, 2 months, 3 months, and you hear the person's name and you feel like puking or something. After that phase, how do people get through the subsequent phases of love, as it were?
There's this amazing book called The Five Love Languages. It's pretty popular. And the man says that this high phase is very important. That's where attraction, you know, is important. You can't marry someone or hook up with someone you're not attracted to. But he said at that time, that high phase, everything is easy. You will do anything. You will drive from Festac to Aja to see your love. You will spend all your money. It's a feeling. But then eventually, when it dies out, that's when the real work of loving each other begins. That's when you start. It becomes an effort. When they say love is an action, it's not a feeling, that's when it kicks in. That's when you have to work at it.
High phase can be classified as infatuation.
That's it.
On all levels, even if it's true love.
Yes, because there is, it's initial, it's not bad. Infatuation has gotten a bad name in that, because some people feel like once the infatuation period is over, the love is over. No, it's just a feeling. And just like you can feel angry one time, sad one time, happy one time, it's a feeling phase, but then the work of love.
Many people don't, you know, I want us to really talk about this because that's the title of the EP. Many people don't understand. They think it's a feeling, you know. When it gets past that stage, I can go for a divorce if I'm married.
I love you, but I'm not in love with you.
But where does that, what do you think about that statement? A lot of people go about with that statement.
Don't crap. Crap. Okay. But there's ignorance. Do you understand? Okay, we're going to say something.
Yeah, I keep wondering. Some people tell you that love doesn't really exist. They tell you, it's just part of this cliche thing, reality, or Hollywood and all that. That in reality, you just have to learn to coexist with the person you're with. How true is that from personal experience?
I think that love very much exists. I think so.
That says such, man.
I think that love exists. I think, though, that I'm grateful that I've come to the stage of my life where I realize that love is beyond feelings. It is even beyond what you do. It's who you are. Do you understand? So love is what? Patient. Love is kind. It is not envious. It's not boastful. It's not proud. It's not rude. It's not self-seeking. It's not easily anchored. That is love. But people don't want to work for love. They just think it should happen. Nah, you gotta earn it.
It's not gonna happen.
That's the unrealistic part of it. Yeah. Most people expect it.
No,
to
you
happen.
Gotta work for love. You gotta work at it day in, day out.
What was the motivation for all the particular love?
I mean, I always think about what I've experienced, right? So the next song on the project is called No. And I had done a song called Okay. Okay is a song that has to do with, I love you, but I'm no longer in love with you, but I've been in a relationship. That feelings phase goes on. You're like, no, you no longer make me happy. I'm going to move on. So you're like, okay, fine. At the end of the day, the sun will not stop shining. It will not stop raining. Grass will not stop growing. I'll be okay. Now, you move on. You're living your life. You're better than before. Then this person that dumped you is showing up trying to be, you know, trying to get back with you. And you're like, no.
No.
So that's no.
And so it's not possible to get back with someone.
No, I mean, you had it. You threw it away, unfortunately. And a lot of times, maybe sometimes there's stuff that people can do to you that there's no, you forgive them, but there's no coming back from. Forgiveness doesn't necessarily mean we come back together. It just means I freed you. I don't hold anything against you.
No grudges.
Shout out to you.
Okay, and then moving on, Shakara, that's the video. Why did you choose this particular song to do a video?
I mean, it's just, it's very good for here. It's a groovy song. It's a fusion of Afrobeat, tribal house, and Niger pop, you know, and soul music, of course, which is my core sound. That's one. Two, I just wanted to show people a different side of me, because people seem to think Ruby is all about R&B, just serious R&B, you know, just slow music, which is a very core part of me. But there's also a side of me that likes to have fun, that likes to dance. So we decided to do something sassy, something fun. And for me, I feel like as a lady, you should not be afraid to indicate interest in a man. I didn't say chase after him, but I'm saying that if you like a guy, you know, you can let him know.
Let the light.
But sometimes
mistake you for flirtation. You'd be like, oh, she's a
flirtation. Flirtation is fine.
She's just nasty.
Yes. We have a call. We have Godwin on the line right here in Lagos. Hello, Godwin. Good morning. Welcome to the show.
Hello, good morning.
Hi, Godwin.
Is that?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Godwin's my boo. Ooh. What's up?
I'm fine.
I should have known you call. How you doing, honey?
I'm fine. I'm okay.
Thank you so much for calling.
I was expecting a
male voice. I really need your voice.
Oh, thank you. You guys, Godwin's an amazing guy. I know he sounds like, it's a guy.
What?
It's a guy. Godwin's a guy.
It's a guy.
It's a guy. Say hi to Godwin. It's a guy. Godwin, my guy.
Godwin.
Hi.
I want to see if I have
Godwin,
I need
Godwin,
to
Godwin, what's your age grade, please?
Godwin is 18.
Oh,
you have, like,
he's a sweetheart.
Okay, he sings, right?
Yes.
Godwin, you sing.
Yeah. He has like a really high pitch.
Okay, Godwin, do something for Ruby. Do something for Ruby.
Okay.
Godwin, do something for Ruby.
Okay. Why you do me Shakara? I don't do you Shakara. Why you do me thing? I don't do you bing. This your own now I do. You want to me to move.
I find it unbelievable.
Godwin, there's a problem here, Godwin. This your voice is just too.
Yes.
It's nice, Godwin. By the way, wonderful
for ladies.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Just Godwin.
Just wow.
Thank you.
I don't even know what to say to you, sir. When did you start singing? Has your voice always been like this? What is this now? This is even.
That's how Yinka is.
Because I listen to a lot of movies.
Are you serious?
Are you role model?
Are you a recording? Are you a recording artist or something?
No, I'm not a recording artist.
Are you planning to be? Are you planning to be? Are you planning to be a recording artist? Are you planning to be?
No.
Oh, why waste your
I like that.
Voice?
I like that. Focus
why?
On your what are you
doing?
What would you want to do? God, what would you want to do?
Well, I want to be I don't really do that for now.
I don't
it's normal, it's okay. You find yourself.
God is not okay.
It's okay, oh my god.
Just
don't put
school.
Yourself under pressure.
He just been this school.
Oh, wonderful voice, Godwin.
Thank you so much.
Godwin, just because of your voice, I'll have entered you now, but then you have a wonderful voice. Thank you very much for calling, Godwin.
Well, thank you.
Bye.
Wow.
Thank you.
Bye. Love you, Ruby.
I love you too.
Wow.
I was on a radio station. I was having an interview a couple days back and he called in. We honestly thought, he said he wanted to remain anonymous. So we just checked online because he tweeted at me and I was like,
wow.
Are you serious?
That's serious.
Okay, so he sang the song. He actually sang Shakara.
Yes.
I wish you guys would have done a duet while he was singing and we were singing together.
So Shakara is out there.
But
it's on radio.
Absolutely. It's on radio. The video is out. Ajebutter 22, Clarence Peter shot it.
Okay.
So you all need to go check it out on YouTube. Okay. Enjoy the video. What I like about this song is simply because, like I said, it's a woman not being afraid to let a guy know she likes, especially if she knows, you guys, we can have something. You know, I know you like me. I like you. Why are we wasting time? YOLO.
Man, those ladies these days, man.
YOLO.
They don't do that anymore,
you
man.
See, ladies do that, but you now say, oh, the ladies
they say
a flirt.
She's, yeah, there's that.
It's not true.
The thing is,
it's true.
There's
it's not true.
When you come
true.
On a guy, she's coming too strong.
It's
she's
not,
loose.
It's not true.
It's
see,
true. Personal experience. It's true.
No, it's not. It's not.
Say it.
It's not. Wait, it's not. The thing. Okay, let's look at it this way now. Really. I don't know. The lady. Okay, how do I put it now? Let me put it this way. The best I can put it is this. Most of the times, the lady, it's not a problem having to give the guy the go ahead. But a lot of times now, when the lady gives a go ahead and then the guy grabs the opportunity. Mm. It's more or less like, I calm down now. I was just trying to, you know, but then I think that more ladies need to be bold enough to show the green light without being too, because yes, the guy is made for the hunt. True. How do I put it that way? He's made for the hunt, and someone's more like an eagle and a vulture. The eagle likes, you know, the meat should be alive. Mm. It shouldn't be brought dead.
Oh, I don't get my point. Don't just lie down.
Yeah. a challenge.
Exactly.
I like that.
But at the same time, you know, I feel that. I've heard stories. I was talking with someone 2 or 3 days ago. I was like, okay, there's this particular guy that has chased a lady for 4 years.
Kai.
And I'm wondering, we have stories like that. Five years. And I'm wondering, like, oh God, what? Does she pick gold?
But does that equate for feminine pride? Like, okay, I have to respect myself.
That's been 4 years. Come on.
That's too much.
Because I'm thinking, does she poop gold? How can you go so far?
Poops gold,
if a guy's gonna go after a lady, then you give the signs. Yes, you might want to, but then give at least let me know that there's progress. Not 2 years down the line, 3 years down the line, you are still forming. Shiloh is your case. So
it's guys like him that would say, oh no, don't form. Then when she does it, and he'll be like, oh come on, it's too much. You're being all over me. You're being too clingy.
You can't
really please
me. I guess it's balance. You have to find enough. You know, just the right balance of, you know, because everybody fears rejection. Everybody, both male, both female. So just to find the right balance.
I know everybody, some guys, man. There's no. We need to keep me.
Moving on next.
On to the next. Let's go to down. Down. What's down?
Down is ride or die, love. Is that I'm here for you no matter what. Good times, bad times, what happy times, sad times. Money, no money, I'm here for you. So that's what down is.
What I feel? I have this feeling that I'm talking to a lot of people out there that, you know, there's some people that have had not so good experiences with love, so many of them. And then, you know, when people like that come together and they actually see that spark, they tend to appreciate each other better.
That's true.
At times, you know, when the lady has had terrible experiences, a lot of them. The guys also had terrible experiences, and then they meet each other and look, the thing don't rock it before. It don't rock it before, man. Let's make this one more try.
Yeah.
I think it tends to make, you know, what do you think about that?
I think because they have the same goal of making the relationship work, it will work.
It does work.
It will work.
Right?
If they are willing to put in the work, if they are willing to put in the effort, the time to make a beautiful relationship. And that's it's like a garden. You're tending to it. So they remove the weeds, you have to water it, you have to till the ground. So yeah, if you have two people that have that same focus, oh my God.
But
epic love.
Two people epic in the love. Same situation.
They need
they're
to
like
be,
that,
yes.
But they're not really certain, like, oh no, this person is like this, let me slow down. This person is like this, let me slow down.
You have to,
how
I
do
think,
you put it? How, what is the perfect situation in that kind of situation? That kind of case?
I think you have to courage. Love is scary. You have to be willing to jump off. You know, you have to be willing to jump off the cliff.
It is.
You know, but I just feel two of you have to be willing to do it. Not that one person will jump and
the other person will be like,
yeah, you heard that story. The man and the wife, they came together and said, we'll jump at the same time. We're tired of life. And then the woman jumps and the man stays back. And the man does, the woman goes down the parachute. So who was cheating who?
So they didn't trust each other from the get.
Exactly.
Oh my God.
So, you know, it's always that, like you said, there's always that human feel of, is this person really going to do it as much as we can't read minds. Mm. You can't know entirely what is in this person's head. The person can't know what is in my head. Maybe it gets to a point, I know people have spoken to each other like, man, look, if I could just see your mind, or you see my mind, we'll just know as it is.
That takes a lifetime.
You know, someone said that if we could hear what the other person says 5 seconds after they drop the call, we won't have so many friends.
Preach.
You know, that's the difference between girls and guys.
Preach. Yeah, I mean, guys just say it.
A guy comes up and say, hey, monkey, idiot, how far now you day? You know, your father, they drop the call. Man, that guy, that correct guy.
Yeah.
When the lady goes, oh, boom, boom, sweetie pie, how you doing? And then she drops the call.
Yeah.
See this one's big. But then, how would you say if... I'm feeling like you're a love doctor now. Maybe you should start it. You love
very soon, guys. Yeah. Watch out. I already do it. I might as well make money off of it. What?
Dr. Ruby.
Yes.
Okay, so in a situation whereby, what kind of advice would you give to somebody where you don't, you can't know what the other person is thinking, but then you want to give so much of yourself, and you are still, you know, you're still trying to wait. There's a bit of, you're vacillating, you're thinking that the other person is not giving so much. How would you counsel someone like that?
I mean, I feel like you can't know everything about a person, but what you can do is watch them. All right, let their actions speak for you. Mm. So give it time. Don't rush into it. Don't fall in love. Lean in love.
Don't fall.
Take it step by step. And as they reveal themselves to you, and as you guys reveal yourself, then you open up more and more. But don't just, you know, too many people have crashed going. I think that for me, you just be cautious, but be open and be willing to try. You have to be willing to try. Love comes with the risk of getting hurt. Mm-hmm. But then what if, on the other hand, it works? Oh my God, it's like heaven on earth. Mm. So it's a risk you have to just be willing to take.
Second option, complete pain, yes. Emotional scar. Yes. How do you deal with that kind of person?
You have to say, there's this book called Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. There's a chapter that is called The Mystery of Sex Transmutation. To transmute is to transform energy from, take energy from one form to another, right? Now, what the guy said in that chapter is, you should never mourn love that passed. You should never be like, oh my God, I lost this loved one, or oh my God, I'll never love again. He said, no, every love you experience prepares you for a greater love. So even though you went, think about the good times of that love and believe that you can even have better than you had before. That's what I've used to get through tough times. Like, no, I will not cheat myself. Love is too wonderful, mm-hmm. an experience to miss out on. So as far as I'm concerned, I expect to have an epic marriage. Mm. Do you understand? I expect, hey, this kind of love that people will be writing about, they'll write songs and books. That's what I expect to have. But you have to be willing to let go of, because it's past. Let it go. Let it go. Work through it. Let that baggage. Don't allow that person, be it a he or a she, to cheat you out of that wonderful love experience. Mm. That's what
wow.
I think.
Yeah, so. Okay, so starting the year on a bang, or with a bang so far.
Yes.
What's your projection for 2016?
Oh my goodness,
I
expect it to be big, you know. I'm looking to put out a lot more music. I'm looking to put out a lot more visuals. I'm looking to perform a lot more than I have in the past. I'm looking to do that
concerts.
A lot more. Yes, concerts. I'm looking to do my own concerts as okay. well. I'm looking to collaborate with people, the unexpected people that will not think Ruby will collaborate.
Exactly. It's because if I see, yeah. seeing Bears here, I'm like, okay,
yeah,
I would expect
they are.
I'm just seeing Ruby yes. and Small Doctor.
you never know, because that's the beauty of music.
Yeah.
It's able, you can fuse it with just about anything. So just, people should expect to be surprised. Pleasantly wow. surprised.
Pleasantly right. surprised.
So should we also expect you and a new show coming up, the collaboration between Chocolate City? Are you going to be a major key player?
Absolutely.
There?
I mean, I'm not
voice
yet.
Voice training, coach,
yes.
or judge.
Well, you know, I'm not going to say much. Y'all watch
yeah,
out.
Exactly.
Look for me.
I just wish a lot of record labels had this fairy tale ending. You know, having loopy music, I know the first time you came here, you were still under loopy music.
Yes.
And then you coming up here as Chocolate City, it's wonderful. I wish record labels will have this kind of fairy tale ending that
yeah,
you know it all ends so much like that. But then let's just look at it. Let's look at the whole let's look at Chocolate City and all of that. How would you, let's see, if you were to give an advice, you know, I don't know, if you were to talk to a record label executive and all mm-hmm. about using Chocolate City as a case study, what would you tell them as per how people should relate when it comes to business and music?
I would just say that people should just be open to each other. Do you understand? I would say that it is important to kind of see things from the other perspective, you
okay
know,
from
the other side, because it will make working together just so much easier. That's really what is understanding that we are a team. It's not you and me, we're together, and if only if we work together that we can make success happen.
Okay.
So for me, that's really it.
You know, I just said this time, you did a cover for Hello, right?
Yes, I did.
I heard your cover. Everyone
yeah.
was like, whoa, Ruby. Maybe you just use it and we'll close this show,
you
right?
Better than
let's
say
your cover,
by the way.
That's all you need to music. You need to music. Do you know when I was recording it, my heart was beating because Adele slayed that song. So in my head, I just kept hearing her voice. So I said, I have to make this song my own. There's no other way. So I started, and towards the end, I was like, okay, excuse me, Auntie Move. Let Ruby handle her business. So
okay.
That's how we just.
So can you take us out with that?
I will try. Even
okay.
There's no music, but I'll try.
Okay, all right.
Okay.
So let's get social media handles. How do we get
okay.
in touch with you? And then you take us out with.
I'm Ruby Gyang on all social media handles. That is RubyGyang. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Google+, everywhere. Ruby Gyang. Search me out. Please send a message. No matter how long, I'll always get back to you. Yeah.
Hmm. That's wonderful. That's wonderful. It's been great having you on the show. Thank,
thank you
so
for
much.
Having me.
It's been the breakfast show. We'll still go on. But then Ruby is taking us out from the other side, okay, from this side.
From this side to the other side.
Let me arrange myself.
Okay.
Uh-huh. All right. Hello from the other side. At least I can say that I've tried to tell you I'm sorry for everything that I've done. It don't matter. It clearly doesn't tear you apart anymore. Hello from the other side.
When we get back to show, we'll go on.
Oh, my God. Thank you. Thank you.